Those of you that have your Bibles with you on today, I will be reading from the 21st century King James Version. And there are three very familiar passages of scripture that I will be using as the foundation of my sermon. And if you would turn to Jeremiah chapter 32, I would like to read in your hearing verse 27. And it reads, "Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me?" If you would go into the New Testament of the Synoptic Gospel of St. Matthew, I will be reading from chapter 19, and I will be reading in your hearing verse 26, and it reads, "But God beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." Go with us over to a very, very familiar passage, and this is 1 Peter chapter 5. And I will be reading in your hearing verse 7. And it reads, "Casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you." Well, thank you the Lord for the reading of the scripture. Now, what the Lord has placed in my spirit for today in a way of a subject may be unusual, but this is what he gives, and so bear with us for a little while. But I want to talk from the subject today, the all-knowing specials. Will you do me a favor right quickly and turn to your neighbor? We found that many things come by touching and agreeing. And I would like for you to repeat after me and say, "Neighbor, God specializes." As I set the metaphor for premise for the spiritual application of this sermon in your hearing, I would like to start by asking how many of you have ever been informed by your primary doctor concerning your health condition that you need to be preferred to a specialist? I remember with my recent medical condition, several people who were concerned about my health and well-being, out of love, they said to me, "You need to be seen by a specialist." Even my daughters, Rochelle and Tiffany, attempted to get me an appointment with a specialist, but were told by the specialist office that for me to see a specialist, I had to be preferred by my primary physician. Well, Webster defines a specialist as a person who concentrates primarily on a particular subject or activity. A person highly skilled in a specific or restricted field. Medical specialists are doctors who complete advanced education in clinical training in a specific area of medicine. Their specialty area. Now, I don't mean any harm, church, but according to the definition of a specialist, they are limited to one specific or restricted field of expertise.
That's right. That's right.
Therefore, I need you, if you're going to get and grasp this message on today, I need you to understand that the all-knowing specialist that I'm talking about today far exceed every earthly specialist. Why? Because the divine specialist that I'm talking about today, he is omniscient. Meaning all-knowing. He is omnipresent, meaning all-present. He is omnipotent, meaning all-powerful. And when we talk about him being all-present, he's ubiquitous. I'll rest for a little while. He's present and appears to be found everywhere at the same time. But he's also omnibenevolent, meaning all-loving. Will y'all do me a favor? Let's consider the confirmation declared by David in Psalms 139, beginning at verse 1, as he gives us a testimony about the greatness of God. He begins to say, "O Lord, thou hast searched me and know me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou understand my thoughts afar off. Thou can pass my way or lie down, and are acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word out, thank the Lord, on my tongue. But thee, O Lord, thy knoweth it altogether. Y'all verse for a little while. Thank you, Lord. Thou hast thee set me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. Well, y'all verse for a little while. Thank you, Lord. Whether shall I go from thy spirit? Whether shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. Well, y'all rest for a little while. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even, thank you, Lord, there shall thy hand lead me. Oh, thank you, Lord. And thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light before me. Yeah, darkness hides not from thee, but thank you, Lord, the night shineth as the day, and darkness and light are both alike unto thee. Oh, thank you, Lord, for thou hast possessed my ruins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. Yes. I will praise, thank you, Lord, thee.
Yes.
For I am fearfully and wonderfully and marvelous are thy works, and my soul knoweth right well. Well, y'all rest for a little while. Now, church, I want you to understand here in this particular text, we see that David is declaring the awesomeness of God. Thank you, Lord, how sovereign he is. And well, y'all rest for a little while. And he is telling us about God's attributes and his ability.